Now, over to Mindanao, one municipality in the province of Llano del Sur, that's the town of Lumbaca Unayan, will have no teachers sitting on its electoral board for fear over their safety. So members of the Philippine National Police will just help manage 19 barangays covered in the town. According to the provincial election supervisor of the province, they have around 1,800 special election board inspectors who are PNP personnel, more than enough to cover for lack of manpower. Security also remains tight in areas in the province following reports of election-related violence. Two voters died in a shooting incident in Llano del Sur just hours before the village and youth council polls. This is according to the Philippine Poll Body Chairman George Garcia, who said reports surrounding the incident are still coming in, but the police have already launched a manhunt for the gunmen. Eight towns in Llano del Sur have been designated as areas of grave concern due to its history of election-related violence.
Well, it happened prior to the voting hours, but unfortunately, we already have the suspects, and we already named the suspects, and their PNP is now in hot pursuit. They're just mere voters, but it would appear that the culprits are also voters or supporters of certain candidates. We are going to go deeper into this incident, and I can promise you that we are going to apprehend.
Garcia also urging Congress to pass a law that would allow the elderly, persons with disability, and pregnant women to vote early during the 2025 elections. For this year's BSKE COMELEC pilot tested early voting for the vulnerable sector.
Perhaps by 2025 onwards, we should now have early voting hours during the conduct of our national and local election, especially in the BSKE by 2025. We are hoping that Congress will be able to pass an early voting law in which we are going to allow our senior citizens, PWDs, and heavily pregnant women, including the IPs, to vote at least 1 week ahead of the scheduled election.
Meanwhile, around 50,000 police officers have been deployed to secure Monday's village and youth council elections. About 100,000 personnel from the Armed Forces of the Philippines were also deployed for the BSKE. The PNP says as of October 27, at least 11 election-related violent incidents have been recorded. Police are also closely monitoring reports of vote buying. It's all systems go for mall voting in Barangay Pitogo, Consolacion Town in Cebu, a first for the area. There will only be 10 polling precincts or 5 clustered precincts voting there, translating to a little over 2,400 voters. Now, all in all, the barangay has some 3,400 voters and 1,500 for the Sangguniang Kabataan. The town of Consolacion is just one of 14 areas in the country with mall voting this election. It's also just one of two in Cebu, the other being in Barangay Parian, Cebu City. Let's now get an update from Lady Vicencio, who's at a Quezon City Mall, which is serving as a polling precinct for today's voting. Lady, hi, what can you tell us?
Hi, Mimi. Voting here in a Quezon City Mall kicked off promptly at 7 a.m., but even before polls opened, a few residents of Barangay Horseshoe here in Quezon City lined up as early as 6 to cast their votes for the Barangay and Sangguniang Kabataan elections. First in line were senior citizens who wanted to make sure that they would be able to vote before outdoor temperatures rise. COMELEC tied up with the malls to offer a more convenient venue, especially for the vulnerable sector like senior citizens and persons with disabilities. Mall voting follows the same process as voting in schools. Voters will still have to line up before reaching their precincts, and the voting itself usually takes 20 minutes since the voting process is manual for BSKE. While mall hours were not adjusted in this particular establishment in Quezon City, the management made sure that restrooms, escalators, and elevators were already accessible to the public. Some food tenants were also encouraged to open early. Mall voting ends at 3 p.m. and will be followed by the counting of votes by the electoral board. Proclamation of winners for villages that have mall voting will also be done in mall. Michelle?
Hi, ladies. So we're expecting... Lady, are you still there? All right. I think we lost your connection, but we do know that COMELEC has said earlier 14 malls in Metro Manila, Cebu, and Albay are participating in the pilot project. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. was an early bird at the barangay elections. He cast his ballot at the Mariano Marcos Memorial Elementary School in Batac, Ilocos Norte at past 7 this morning. Pia Gutierrez has more, and she filed this report.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. was among the first to cast his votes here at the Mariano Marcos Memorial Elementary School in his hometown in Batac, Ilocos Norte for the barangay elections. This year, the Philippine leader arrived in the school just a few minutes after the polling precincts opened. He was accompanied by his son, Ilocos Norte, Representative Sandro Marcos. The president then proceeded straight to polling precinct 36A, where he was listed as a voter number 70. It only took him a few minutes to cast his votes, after which he was able to grant the media a short interview. And in the interview, the president said that the government will continue to enforce all the laws against election violence as well as vote buying. This amid reports that vote buying is still rampant in many parts of the country. He says that government will not allow vote buying to be a part of the campaign. He says that even here in his hometown, Ilocos Norte, has been receiving reports that some candidates were still trying to buy people's votes, even on the eve of the elections itself.
There were some reports, even here in Ilocos Norte, na may mga umiikot na namimili ng boto para dito sa barangay election. Well, syempre lahat ng yung mga kapulisan natin, yung mga COMELEC natin, ginagawa ang lahat para itigil na ganun. Pagka makatanggap kami ng report, pinapupuntahan ko kagad. Ang aking payo lang sa ating mga kababayan ay huwag nyo naman itatapon ang inyong karapatan na makapili ng mga inyong mga barangay official. Dahil alam nyo naman po na ang mga barangay official ang mga kaharap ninyo araw-araw. Ito ang mga tinatakbuhan ninyo para makatulong sa inyong mga problema. Kaya kung idadaan lang sa bayaran, ay hindi kayo mawawala yung boses ninyo.
The president also said that the results of the barangay elections is going to have a significant effect on the results of the midterm elections and subsequently in the national polls as well. This, as he noted, the influence that barangay officials have on their own constituents. Voting in the same precinct are members of the extended Marcos clan, including the president's own mother, Imelda Marcos, the former first lady, as well as Ilocos Norte Governor Matthew Joseph Marcos Manotoc and Vice Governor Cecilia Araneta Marcos. We're still waiting for them to arrive as of the moment. The president's family, meanwhile, is expected to cast their votes in Lawag, where they are registered as voters.
Although majority of voters for today's elections will have to cast their ballots manually, some select areas are piloting automated polls. Our correspondent, Andrea Taguines, is at one of those sites in Quezon City, and she now joins us for the latest. Andy, go ahead. Hi.
Good morning, Michelle. More and more people are arriving here at the Pasong Tamo Elementary School in Quezon City to vote for the village and youth elections. Over 32,000 people are expected to be voting here at this school. But so far, based on what we're seeing and the people that we've spoken to, the actual voting process has been quick and smooth because, as you said, unlike in most polling centers, the voting here is automated. They're using vote counting machines as part of the COMELEC pilot testing this year. So instead of having to manually write down their chosen candidates, voters would just have to shade the oval next to the name of their bets. One PWD voter we spoke with, a person with disability, said that she was done in about 3 minutes, and she even took her time double-checking her ballot. She said she also did not have to line up for long since she voted in the accessible polling place, which is really designated for PWDs and senior citizens. But even those who voted in the regular clustered precinct, they said they also had an easy time. Meanwhile, we've also heard of instances of paper jams in vote counting machines, but they were also quickly resolved.
Katulad lang din po siya nung nakaraan na pag bumoto ka, may pagkakataon talagang magpe-paper jam. Pero ano naman siya na maayos naman siya kaagad. May mga supporting person naman po na pwede namin tawagin pag nagkaroon po ng aberya po sa voting machine.
Michelle, right now we're seeing a bit of crowding behind me at the voters assistance desk of the Parish Pastoral Council for Responsible Voting, or PPCRV, because a lot of voters coming here do not yet know what their precinct number is or which room that corresponds to exactly. So one tip that the PPCRV and the COMELEC suggests is to first check the website of the COMELEC for its precinct finder, so that when they come here they already have an idea of where to go. But then again, there are also instances like one lady we spoke to a while ago, her records could not be found even though she was able to vote last May 2022. So she was really shocked that her name wasn't found in the records and she could not vote. She tried asking for assistance and they were just telling her that they couldn't find her records. So they were dismayed and they just went home. Meanwhile, aside from this school, automated voting is also being pilot tested in two other areas here at the 6th District of Quezon City. That's in Judge Feliciano Belmonte Senior High School and in the CBE Town Covered Court. That also means quicker canvassing of votes. The COMELEC expects to get the results for the elections in these areas just an hour after voting closes at 3 p.m. Michelle?
Andy, just very quickly, so everybody, the voters there, still familiar, they still remember how to vote in the automated polls?
Yes, Michelle, they're telling us that this is where they also voted last time and they also voted through the automated process. So it wasn't really that difficult for them. And in case they do find difficulty in voting, there are people to assist them inside the polling precincts. They have the teachers there. There are poll watchers there to assist them. Even when the machine gets paper jammed, there are also people that they can approach to assist them. Michelle.
And finally, Andy, do we know what was the basis for the COMELEC in selecting which areas will be pilot testing the automated polls for this barangay and youth council elections?
Michelle, we'll try to learn more about that, but we know that here at the Pasong Tamo Elementary School in Quezon City, we are conducting automated voting, and we're also conducting in other places in Dasmariñas. We'll try to learn more about if this was a randomized selection for the automated voting or if it was purposeful.
All right. Thank you very much for that update, Andy Tanginas, joining us live. Hundreds of early morning voters continue to flock to the Taguig National High School for the Barangay and Sangguniang Kabataan elections. Included on the list of early voters would be several persons deprived of liberty. Let's now get an update from Liza Aquino, who joins us live. Liza, hi. What's going on there?
PBM currently here in Taguig National High School, one of the biggest polling precinct for this District 1 of Taguig City. And we could already see long queues forming as hundreds of early voters flocked to the area for the village and youth elections. Mimi, around 44,830 voters in 89 clustered precincts are expected to cast their votes within the day. Some voters, mostly senior citizens, PWDs, and pregnant women, came as early as 6 a.m. to cast their votes to avoid the long queues. Included on the list of early voters are some persons deprived of liberty, or PDLs, from BJMP who casted their votes off-site. According to Police Captain J.M. Sabiniano, jail warden of BJMP Metro Manila District Jail Annex 2, they weren't given a COMELEC permit to conduct on-site voting as they did not meet the minimum quota of registered and qualified voters for PDLs. They assisted their PDLs off-site alongside Taguig PNP for the safety and security of the voting public who are also in the said precinct today.
Offside kasi hindi natin na-reach yung minimum number of qualified voters na 50. Kami sa BJMP naniniwala na ang pagboto ng ating mga kababayan na kukulong basta qualified ay napakahalaga. Kung kaya binibigyan natin ito ng oras, panahon at effort.
PDLs casted their votes at around 7 a.m. and were immediately brought back to Camp Bagong Diliwa. And that's the latest here in Taguig. Back to you, Mimi.
Thank you very much for that update, Liza Aquino, joining us live from Taguig. Just for context, there were over 31,000 persons deprived of liberties set to vote today. And also on the automated polling that's being pilot tested by COMELEC, we do remember that COMELEC actually approved the testing of automated election system for only three different villages for this year's village and youth council elections. That was announced earlier this year around February. The pilot testing is being done in two villages in Dasmariñas City, Cavite, and one in Pasong Tamo, Quezon City, as Andrea Taguines earlier reported. Today's Barangay and Sangguniang Kabataan elections is happening more than 5 years since the last polls on May 2018. It's also the first nationwide elections under the administration of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. So, here are the numbers you need to remember today. 42,001. This is the number of barangays in the Philippines, also the same number of posts for chairpersons of barangay and SK up for grabs. We're also looking at 828,644. This is the total number of candidates for barangay chairpersons and kagawad. And 585,843. That's the total number of candidates for SK chairpersons and members. Now, the barangay with the biggest population is in Caloocan City. That's Barangay 176. That barangay has 90,209 registered voters. While Barangay Di Barusan in Madamba, Llano del Sur is the community with the least number at just 53. 5 is important. That's 5 pesos. This is the amount that any candidate may spend per voter during the 10-day campaign period. And if you're wondering how much these officials are getting paid, 33,843 pesos is the maximum monthly honorary of barangay chairperson in special cities or first-class cities, while 21,998 is the maximum monthly honoraria of barangay chairpersons in sixth-class municipalities. Now, Lente is reminding the public, the Barangay and Sangguniang Kabataan elections in the Philippines is not just a local affair, and that these leaders are architects of local communities responsible for the delivery of vital services and in shaping the very foundation upon which our democracy stands. Its impact, therefore, it says, extends far beyond the grassroots. Lente also notes the barangay and SK officials that we will elect will only have 2 years to serve this time, and our pandemic experience has shown how our quality of life can flourish with efficient and proactive barangay and Sangguniang Kabataan leaders, and how it can significantly deteriorate with inefficient and self-serving officials in place.